This morning in Legal Logic, since it is Super Tuesday, we are talking libel and slander. Yeah, and here to break down the difference between political and non-political speech is attorney Brian Cunha. Good morning, Brian.
Good morning, Brian.
As usual.
Yeah, great to see you.
Super Tuesday.
Yeah, so fitting to have you here.
Here we are.
We've all been watching, you know, these debates, the candidates on the campaign trail, and we think, how can they get away with what they're saying? So break it down for us as to why there's a difference between what politicians can say and what us common folk can say.
It's because they're public figures. The founders back when thought that there's a difference between being a public figure and a private figure. And we have these things known as libel and slander, which are defamatory things. In other words, saying something that's untruthful that harms someone's reputation.
Right.
You and I can't say the same kind of things that a public figure can say about another public figure.
Even though technically, I mean, I'm not a big deal, but we're on TV. In some respect, somebody might consider us a public figure, not on the level that they are, but there's a difference there.
The reason is because our democracy wants open and vigorous debate. And character is always an issue when you're talking about a public figure.
Right.
And because character is an issue, you can go after the person's private life, their family life, all those sorts of things, because the Supreme Court and the founders wanted this really vigorous, open, loud, boisterous debate, free flow of ideas, and that goes only with public figures, but it does not necessarily go with you or I. In other words, if I said something to a judge that was untruthful, or improper, I'd be in trouble, but not necessarily with a public figure.
It really is amazing to think we see these candidates vying, jockeying for position here, and they all want to be the nominee.
Right.
But when we watch them, it seems, it really resembles a circus at times, and it's almost encouraged to a certain degree because of the laws.
The Supreme Court has actually said that they want emotional, vigorous, sometimes misleading debate. And in fact, the most famous case is the 1964 case, New York Times versus Sullivan. Mm-hmm. And what the case said is it's okay to be a little bit untruthful in political discourse, believe it or not.
And when you watch that.
So that's why we have what we got.
Well, it's so important that you break it down for us because I think all of us watch it and we think, how can that be done? And it really is so rudimentary when you break down the law, isn't
it? How can you libel someone? You know, it's in writing. How can you slander someone, something orally? How can you say something that's just downright seems untruthful?
Right.
But it's our system.
I really did want to. I was hoping you'd tell me that I'd be able to make up stuff about people here today, but I guess I can't do it.
You can say anything about me.
It'll be untruthful, but I'll say it anyway. I do think the world with you. Thank you very much, Brian. If you would like even more legal information from Brian Cunha, just head on over to roadshow.com and click on the Legal Logic channel.